Hello, today we've planted some plants, which is brilliant. Best thing about gardening, planting, seeding, all that sort of stuff. It was funny, so I had the plants ready to go in, and it's funny how they didn't look that many, but then when you put the plants ready to plant, there looks loads. Planting them seems like loads, and then when they're actually in, they seem to have all disappeared again. It's uncanny. I'm sure many a person's been to a garden centre, bought a whole trolley full of plants, put them in the garden and been like, I don't know where they've gone. And that's kind of this case, not quite. There is still, it's still a very big difference. And one of the best things about making these videos is I can see how it was before and how it is now. So yeah, lots of plants have gone in. It's just, it's unbelievable how much stuff I've removed. So obviously this area where the plants have gone, it's been dug with a digger. That was to break it up. It's been raked to get rid of some of the main rocks left behind. It's been rotivated so it's diggable. It's been raked again. And then even this time, so I had to go across it all with my spade and a fork. And then even then, I still managed to get out a whole wheelbarrow of nice stones, which I'll use for ponds and things like that, and still rubble rocks. I think, I just accept that that's gonna be, we're gonna have rocks for like many, many years. Anyway, extra bonus for this one, I had my mom helping me, which was good. So putting workforce best done, mom planting, me digging. So it was just a case of digging, and it was hard work really. It's fine when when the soil's good, but this is not good soil. So I just thought I'd show you these. If you look at these flowers, and they're really beautiful flowers. They kind of like remind me of hyacinths a bit. And I think it's one of those examples where you can walk past stuff and not notice all the time. So all of these are all from that horse chestnut tree. So every single one of those is these flowers, which is amazing, I'd say. Really impressive. Anyway, I don't know if you remember, we had the owl box up there, two of them, and they are up there somewhere, but I don't know if it's because we pulled the soil away from the trunk or whether... because there was a few, like there was a bit of insulation foam up against it. I'm sure it wouldn't have made that big a difference. However, the tree just looks very, very happy. One of the neighbours very nicely said they've never seen it. It's the best they've ever seen it. It will need to get trimmed back a bit in autumn, but we're waiting till autumn then, because there's certain times of the year when it's best to do it. So here is where we planted. So there should be like a nice list running across of what all the plants are on the video now. I try and save them, but I don't want to risk it, so it's better to have them written down. We're going to put some more at the back bit, just because it's very shaded there, and obviously because of the tree, it'll be drier and shaded, so whatever goes there, we need to sort out that. I'll work that out at the moment. But all of this area now, I do plan to change it in certain bits. For example, I'd like a stream. But the problem is the stream is going to cost money. So at the moment, it's just a case of what can I do, which is just effort, really. And hopefully these are all nicely distributed. I've got a lot of bulbs I'm going to put in as well, which I've already got them. And the idea is this, it'll just fill all of this area. So this is all going to be, and these are all positive for bees, birds, things like that. That plant over there particularly gets really lovely purple berries on it, which the birds really like. So yeah, it's just a case of let it grow now. It's been in for about, I don't know, a week now, and less than that even, and everything looks established. We've been very lucky, we've had some good rainfall, so that's always makes things easier, so I don't have to water it at all. And yeah, I'm really pleased. So this is a the woodland garden, shall we say. I am going to have some trees at some point, maybe a rowan, which is sometimes known as a bird tree because I like it that much, and it's got the orange berries on it. But because we're going to trim this, well, I'm just going to let it do what it does this year, really. And this, I mean, it's just absolutely gorgeous, the flowers on this. You can see there's bees everywhere. Yeah, you only need to look up and there's bees all over it. It's such a great tree. I've always liked horse chestnuts, and I've always just associated them with, you know, conker fights as a kid and stuff. But actually seeing it in bloom, it's really, really taken it to a new level for me. They are absolutely gorgeous. I don't know if there's an owl in there or not. Obviously we've had the owl having a bath in the pond. So the owls are in the area, but if they are in the box, it's very hard to see them just now. But yeah, the woodland garden, hope you're liking it. We're really making good progress. The weather's great, it's brilliant. Summer's here. If you enjoyed it, please like, comment, subscribe. I really appreciate it. And yeah, thanks for watching.